It's summer vacation, and I'm in this room of my classroom, which is normally a computer lab. All the computers are gone, but it usually looks something more like this. Here's my problem. Last summer, I spent the entire summer rebuilding a broadcast studio in this door, and it took like the whole summer. Came out great though. This summer, my project is to fix this room because currently it's really not functional at all. It's in these rows, and that sucks, and it's really hard to move. Here's why. Down here on this side, all of these outlets provide network connections. So we need these so every computer is connected to the internet. Every table has the wiring mounted to it, so right now they're all connected in these rows. And then on this side is where all the power is. So I guess the original idea was power comes on one side, network comes on the other, and then every computer has power and internet. But it sucks because I hate teaching in rows. It's really uncomfortable, it's really crowded. Like this space right here, if anybody is sitting here, it's pretty much impossible to walk through here. I'm going to spend however long it takes to redo this space and make it comfortable and functional and practical and usable. And the first step is going to be removing the wires from all of these tables. About an hour into this, I have most of the tables unplugged, unwired. I hate rows, and I hate it when students have to be like piled on top of each other. So what I'm trying to do is create like work spaces and areas where if someone wants to work by themselves, it's easy. If one or two people want to work together, it's easy. Or if a whole group want to work together, it's easy, but nobody has to be like stacked on top of one another. And I think I have an arrangement that I actually like that will work. And it looks sort of strange. Now, my extra credit assignment would be to see if I can actually fit an extra table in here because honestly, at the start of the school year especially, I usually have more students in this room than the room can handle. And to avoid having to have kids sit on the counter or the floor, if I can get more seats, it will make things more manageable because see, we can go over here, which is my other classroom that I haven't quite gotten back in order yet for the new school year. There's plenty of space here, but this room can only support about 12 computers. And this big empty space over here is really more of like a production space that's cleared out and kids can film things, we can set up photo shoots and stuff like that. There is this big wall that divides the two classrooms and I'm actually trying to get that torn down because that would solve all of my problems. But in the meantime, this is the room that has most of the computers in it, so especially at the start of the year, this is the room where we spend most of our time. But now that I have this figured out, and I did add a bonus table, it's more comfortable in here, it's less crowded in here, it's now wheelchair accessible, which it wasn't before, and it can actually hold two more students and two more computers than it could before. So I'm pretty proud of myself. The next step is to figure out how to wire all this up. My goal is today's Monday. By the end of this week, I would really like to have this just perfectly ready to go. Day two, my goal today is to wire everything up. I actually have more seats than computers. So that means not every spot needs to be wired, which is great because it's gonna reduce the amount of wires I have to run. So before I do the wiring, I actually wanna bring in all the computers and place them where they need to go. And ideally this is like the front corner of the classroom. It's where I can see the most screens possible. So in a spot like this, where I wouldn't have as good visibility of the screen from up here, I'm only put one computer there instead of two. That's what I'm gonna do now is bring in all the computers, place them, and then wire them. It is now 3 o'clock. Stayed a bit later, look and feel terrible, but every computer is plugged into power. Almost every computer has internet, and It's starting to look and feel a lot better in here. It's just so much work. What do you have to say about it?
I love it. I mean, seriously, the difference.
Here we go for day 3. 8 o'clock in the morning. By the end of today, this should be a fully functional lab, and I'm real excited about that. Still have a few of these big like network and power things that I need to get set up, so I wanna get that taken care of.
There was a pretty big issue with power management because the way I arranged this, this small group of only 4 computers ended up with 2 power sources, whereas this giant group of like 15 computers ended up with 1. And this group also ended up with no network access. So I just had to run some cables under this mat, which then I taped down so it shouldn't be an issue or a safety problem. But to do this, then I had to run network cables over here so that these computers have network access. And then I also had to run power from here to here so that way all of these other computers aren't going off of 1 power source.
I've always been a huge believer in, especially classrooms, trying to do non-traditional arrangements that are more effective for that subject matter, using different furniture, different arrangements, different lighting, because we're also used to these like office type environments with fluorescent lighting and just rows of desks and like a cubicle situation, and that's just not how a lot of people can function practically. And so it's really important to me that when students or anybody comes into my classroom and sits down to do something that they feel comfortable, productive, and like they're in a space where they can actually get something done. Three days and it's done. Finally got every computer wired and set up. I'm super excited about this because once the school year starts, I spend most of my time here in this classroom. And it's a really great environment, and the fact that this area was not super effective and now it is, it's a massive relief, and it's been like giving me nightmares all summer, and now it's done. So I am really, really happy, really proud, and now I actually can't wait for the first day of school, which is a very good way to feel. So in the meantime, let me know what you think down in the comments below, and if you haven't subscribed, please make sure to do so, and I will see you guys next time. Oh, I am so tired.